top players like Ronaldo and Romario used to play right here at PSV. And not even that long ago, PSV reached the semi-finals of the Champions League with players like Aurelio Gomez, Jason Park and Jefferson Farfán. But lately, with transfer fees going through the roof, it's getting harder and harder to keep up for a Dutch club with modest means. That's why the club decided to start focusing on their youth academy, and not without success, because they've sold Memphis Depay for a record amount to Manchester United. And other players like Jeroen Zoet and Steven Bergwijn are currently in the first team on a regular basis. So the question is, what can we expect of PSV and its youth academy in the years to come?
A young striker from Rio de Janeiro was included in Brazil's World Cup squad for USA 94. He didn't play in any matches, but it was all part of his development, being around more experienced players and learning how to excel under pressure. So where next for this 17-year-old forward with the world at his feet? The boy called Ronaldo decided upon a move to Holland, leaving Cruzeiro for PSV to play in the Eredivisie by making a transfer worth 5.5 million euros. A large factor in the decision was his international teammate Romario, who had left PSV for Barcelona a year earlier after playing for PSV for 5 seasons. In this period, PSV brought in stars from outside the club to compete for honors in the Eredivisie. But Ajax, who won both the title and the European Cup in 95, achieved these goals with key players coming from their own academy. A philosophy PSV's head coach Mark van Bommel can identify with today.
Ideally, what percentage of the first team will be brought up by PSV?
Yes, as much as possible. But you cannot say now we have to 50% of our squad has to be Dutch or from our own academy. It would be perfect if you have the whole squad, but that's also not possible because you have to have a good mix from ages and different styles of play.
There's many more South American players who came here young and then moved on to the biggest clubs in the world. So that's one part of the scouting, I think, and the other part is more and more homegrown players. Now, when I look behind me, the first team training, I see a lot of players that I worked with,
yeah,
and that are doing well in the first team. So the last 5 years, I think, many players, many more players than PSV used to produce from their youth program are coming through now.
In the summer of 94, when Ronaldo first arrived, Ernest Faber was returning to PSV from a loan spell at FC Groningen. Born on the outskirts of Eindhoven, he made his first team debut for PSV in 1990 and stayed with the club until he retired in 2004.
Ernest, you've been at PSV in many different roles, first
yes,
as a youth player and as a first team player.
Yes.
And now as the director of the youth academy. How special is PSV for you?
PSV is like a family for me. I started here when I was 12, I'm now 47. I did many jobs within the club.
Back in the day, PSV used to be famous for buying big players such as Ronaldo and Romario. They were here when you were here. Was it exciting back then? How did you look at it?
Yeah, I was a young player in that time in that selection. So there were big stars who were able for PSV to buy them here within this club.
Would it still be possible to get players like that, or do we have to look at the level below that?
Now, if you see what the big clubs are paying for players without within Holland, you know, some big players we PSV sold, Memphis, and that amount is too big for our club. But our unique selling point is how we develop young players in this country.
The sale of Memphis Depay for €34 million in May 2015 to Manchester United is currently the biggest transfer fee received in the club's history.
Als je kijkt naar bijvoorbeeld Memphis Depay, hoe zijn route is gegaan, is dat dan zeg maar een beetje de ultieme route? Opkomen via de jeugdopleiding, dan een paar jaar in het eerste spelen en dan voor veel geld een transfer maken?
Ja, zeker. Ik met Memphis ook mee in de busjes gezeten dat we van school werden opgehaald. En dan zie je hem ontwikkelen. Dat is eigenlijk alleen maar, ja, denk ik, hoe PSV dat ook heel graag ziet. Zeker. Ja. En dat zie je nu ook bij ons in het team, dat een aantal jongens vanuit de jeugd doorstromen, meetrainen en een goede indruk maken.
Steven Bergwijn is probably the next guy going out for a high number. Would you say he's at the same level right now as Memphis Depay was when he left PSV?
Yeah. It's close to. It's always difficult to compare players, but if you see the qualities, he was playing more or less on the same position. Then he has. It can be possible that they paid almost the same amount as for Memphis. Of course, wingers are always interesting, but it's not easy to tell that that's 40 million. So sell him.
Steven Bergwijn left the Ajax Academy for PSV at the age of 13 and has been with the club ever since. In the 2018-19 season, Bergwijn scored 14 goals in 33 appearances for the first team, playing as an attacking winger.
Want vorig jaar heb je natuurlijk nog even bijgetekend, maar deze zomer moet het toch een beetje gaan gebeuren, toch?
Nou ja, ik ben pas 21, ik heb geen haast. Maar het moet gewoon iets goeds komen met een goed plan. En zo niet ben ik hier gewoon prima op mijn plek.
Heb je het gevoel dat je er klaar voor bent?
Ja, mocht er iets komen, dan ben ik er wel klaar voor. Ja.
Another PSV player piquing the interest of clubs all over Europe is Mohamed Iataren.
He joined the winter break training camp with the first team and he just blew everybody away there. That's not normal with 16 years of age.
With the ball, it's extraordinary for his age.
The way he developed is spectacular.
Ja, gewoon een fantastisch speler.
Just developed as a rocket, really.
Ja, maar je was 8 toen je bij de jeugdopleiding van PSV kwam. Wanneer kwam je erachter dat je wat beter was dan de rest en dat je profvoetballer ging worden?
Zo, op mijn 6 dan. Nee, veel eerder.
Ja?
Ja, veel eerder.
Want is altijd je droom geweest om profvoetballer te worden?
Ja, ik had niks anders eigenlijk.
Nee?
Alleen voetbal, ja.
Hoe kwam je terecht bij PSV?
Ja, zo. Mijn broer vertelde me een keer aan dat ik een toernooi speelde. En daar een scout liep van PSV en dat ik... Dat ik een keer een uitnodiging krijg.
Ja.
En toen de uitnodiging eenmaal thuis kwam, wist ik het gelijk aan.
Het was een week lang feesten.
Ja. En ik was er nog niet, hè.
Now is the biggest important period coming. Can he hold his path, his focus to make the same steps, the same road when he reached his main target,
yeah,
to get to the first team? Then he was young, talented. Now he's still young and talented, but he has to perform. Now they don't see if you're 17. Okay, he's 17, but you have to perform. You play a wide, yeah, or play bad. So that pressure, you have to handle the coming years.
It's good that he's with us because he's developing really well, but it's also getting a little bit bumpy with him because that's normal.
Mm-hmm.
He's 17, but I think he's learning more here than at the youth academy.
Well, it's official.
Is it a big relief when he decided to sign a new contract? Because I can imagine that if you invest a lot of years into a player and then another club comes along and picks him out, that can be very rough for a club.
Yeah, that's the most difficult part for a club, and also the most dangerous moment, because he can go if he wanted to go. We couldn't do anything, so we are happy that he signed the contract. That he stays for a couple of years and then maybe we can sell him. But first of all, we have to enjoy his qualities.
Kijk je bijvoorbeeld ook naar Memphis Depay, die eigenlijk ook via PSV bij het eerste elftal was gekomen en toen een grote transfer gemaakt heeft?
Ja, natuurlijk. Want ik keek altijd wedstrijden van PSV en ook toen hij hier speelde vooral. Ik keek gewoon iedere wedstrijd naar hem. De stap die hij toen maakte naar United, vond ik wel mooi, want hij is wel via de voordeur weggegaan.
Ja.
Dat wil ik ook.
Het gaat best hard op het moment, hè?
Ja. Kan nog harder. Nee.
The club's pedigree for developing young players is no secret anymore. Now PSV is a credible competitor when it comes to attracting the world's best young players.
What can you tell me about Richie Ledesma?
Richie joined us 6 months ago from the US.
I play the 10 or the 8 or the 6. I can play the 6 also. But I'm more flashy, so I like going forward.
10's your favorite?
Yeah, 10's my favorite, obviously.
What are your qualities?
I like to assist more, not goal scorer, but assist, you know, that's my thing.
How have they welcomed you? Did they help you finding a place and everything?
Yeah, home, I got a home. They helped me with my nutrition stuff, my food, how I eat. Because I came a little chubby when I was here, I guess.
Oh yeah, is that so? It's a cultural thing, you think?
I think so, yeah.
So no more McDonald's?
No more McDonald's, no, for sure, yeah.
Why did you choose PSV?
I chose PSV because it's a good club, like behind the history and stuff, and they play football obviously, and one of the reasons I came here.
You see players from abroad, especially England now, many players are interested to come and join our academy because they see the quality of staff and quality of facilities here, and of course what's maybe just as important is the chances you will get here to get into the first team actually. And I think in a lot of Premiership teams it's difficult of course to get as a young player 17, 18, 19 years old to join directly the first team.
Jeroen Zoet joined the PSV Academy at the age of 15 and progressively moved up through the age groups, going out on loan to RKC Waalwijk for 2 seasons until he made his first team debut in July 2013. Zoet had opportunities to move on, Newcastle and Arsenal were set to be chasing him, but now 28, he is a key member of PSV's first team.
Want werd er een soort traject voorgeschoteld toen je die overstap maakte?
Nou ja, kijk, je gaat hierheen en ik heb hier een week ongeveer meegetraind. Ik heb wat dingen bekeken in Eindhoven, de school waar ik heen zou gaan. En uiteindelijk maakte ik de keuze. En daarin ben ik ook bij het gastgezin langs geweest waar ik als eerste heen ben gegaan. Nou, dat voelde op dat moment goed. Dat is later wat anders gelopen. En ja, toen ben ik eigenlijk terechtgekomen in een gastgezin waar ik nu nog steeds goed contact mee heb.
Heb je toen ook getwijfeld op een gegeven moment om gewoon weer te vertrekken? Of?
Nou ja, je bent jong en dan gaat er van alles door je hoofd. Je zit in een leeftijd waarin ja, ook andere dingen interessant zijn. Maar voor mij was het vooral ja, door de week naar school en trainen. Op zaterdag de wedstrijd.
Ja.
En zaterdagmiddag met mijn vader en moeder weer terug naar Veendam. Zondag thuis en maandagochtend weer in de trein naar Eindhoven.
Ja.
Zo zag mijn week er een beetje uit.
Lang veel tijd in de trein doorgebracht in die tijd.
Ja, absoluut. En dat was soms wel moeilijk in het begin. Dat je dan maandagochtend weer terug gaat. Maar als ik dan eenmaal hier was, dan was het allemaal wel goed.
When do you feel most successful in your job?
When the first team is there are 20 players in the first team, first selection. If they're all players from out of our academy, then we did it very well. And they did a great job.
But what is the goal? Like half of the first team?
At least the half, yes.
Okay, all right.
Yes. I think our own defenders, the hardworking guys, we have to put them from out of this area. Area is an area of typical hardworking guys. Not talk too much, but okay, everything for the club.
How would you describe the right path for a football player? Would it be, for example, you played at Fortuna before coming to PSV? Is that the right path, or would you say it's better now to go to a big club and follow the youth academy?
Oh, for every player, it's a different way. I was 22. I came to PSV. Then I became captain in my second year. Then afterwards, you make several steps. But I was 28 when I went abroad. And now the players are 18, 19, 20, 21.
Looking back, do you think you made all the right choices?
Maybe.
Feel story
I,
there.
I had a really nice career and I enjoyed it, but maybe I went a little bit late abroad, but that was the time, you know?
Yeah.
Players stayed longer at the club at the age you were 25 and older. You went abroad and now they are 16, 17.
Do you think that's one of the biggest problems football is facing today, that there are a lot of other people who are interested in making money out of the football players?
I think it's up to the player, because in the end the player decides. We need to develop the players to make up their own minds about their careers, about the steps they're going to make, because there's people around them who have a lot of opinions, but it's the player himself who needs to decide if he's going from Heerenveen to Valencia, or is it the next step, a top team in his own country, yeah, and then see where he can get. For example, and if a player has a clear idea about that, to build a career in sports, I think you need that continuity and decision making.
Yeah.
And that's what we stand for, at least in our academy.